My name's Kyle Gill. I'm the forest manager at the Cloquet Forestry Center, which is the University of Minnesota's research and experimental forest. The stand we're in today is our example of a white pine shelter wood. A shelter wood is a certain silvicultural technique that tends to favor white pine because of its shade mid tolerance. This stand was originally planted, I think, in the early 1900s. Basically, it's an even-aged white pine stand that used to have a little bit of red pine representation too. And in 2004, they decided to cut out all the red pine and try and promote white pine in the understory. All of these white pine trees were left on site in order to provide seed for future regeneration. A lot of our white pine were logged off in between 1910 and 1920. When the land was donated to the University of Minnesota, the timber company retained the rights of the timber, and white pine was the high value timber of that era. So a lot of Minneapolis and Chicago and St. Paul and Milwaukee were built with white pine, not necessarily right from here, but from white pine in this region. So a lot of the white pine population was taken off the landscape. To have this group of mature white pine is kind of a rare thing right now. That's what makes this stand unique, is that we don't have a lot of areas that are full of mature white pines, so full of a mature seed source for the next generation of white pines on the landscape. The value really depends on the objectives that the landowner had. So our primary objective here is to try and promote white pine on the landscape. And so the value that we have here is to make sure that we have white pine now and that we have white pine in the future. If we had a specifically timber objective, then we would look at, to assess the value, we would look at the diameter of the trees and the straightness of the trees and whether or not there are any big crooks in the trees. White pine blister rust doesn't only affect young trees, but it can affect older trees too, and as well as the white pine weevil. And a lot of times when you look at a white pine, you go about halfway up and you see a big crook in the tree, and that's usually because the white pine weevil took out the leader, or white pine blister rust affected that portion of the tree, and another limb had to take over as leader. And so that really reduces its value in terms of a timber product, but it doesn't reduce its value as a seed source. And so for us, I don't care that much that these trees have some crooks in them, because I want them to retain them on the landscape as a seed source. So what I see for assessing the value depends on what my longer term objective is. And that can vary. That'll vary from one stand to the next, and from one landowner to the next. So we have at the Forestry Center, we have a variety of objectives, and we manage different stands differently depending on those objectives. A lot of the white pine that we had on the forest a while ago was initially logged off in the 1910s, and so it's been an underrepresented species. So the goal for promoting white pine regen was to get more white pine back on the Cloquet Forestry Center landscape specifically, but then also in the larger landscape. One of the big issues, and the reason it's a little bit reduced on the landscape, is that there have been pathogens such as white pine blister rust that limit white pine's ability to establish itself in the canopy. So the big issues that we're facing in this stand that we're trying to watch out for is primarily the deer. When I walk through the stand, I notice that there's been a lot of deer activity, and the deer cams that we've set up in here show that there's some highways that walk through here. So the way that we're trying to combat that is by using a pretty standard technique called bud capping, which is basically a piece of paper that you put around the top buds of the white pine regeneration, because the buds are what the deer go after when it comes to pine, and they get a boost of nutrients from it, but then that means that pine tree can no longer grow because of the characteristics of growth that they have as a species. The deer definitely use the stand. So this is a great place in the winter to have some thermal cover. They're gonna be able to eat some of the white pine buds. If we can make sure they don't eat all of them, that serves our purpose of having a future white pine forest. But then it's also good for the deer population. There are healthy insect populations in this stand. I assume there's a lot of ticks that we'll find as we walk out of the woods. There are definitely plenty of mosquitoes, and that's good for the birds. So if we're thinking about from the ground up, basically, or the small animals up to the large animals, a forest like this supports the insects well, and which supports the birds, and the birds support the mammals, and the plant life also supports the mammals. And so I think we see a pretty good stand here in terms of providing for wildlife habitat.